Hello everyone. Today we are here with Deadly Horror 101.
Hey.
Is there anything you would like to say before we get started?
Not much, really.
All right. You are a narrator, so we'll go ahead and dive right into those questions for you.
All right.
How did you come up with your channel name?
Well, I was thinking of a name for on February 22nd. I was thinking of a name for the channel, and I started doing it at that day. I read a 15 paragraph. Avoiding the question, but I was thinking of a name. I was thinking of, Horror Studio One. Well, him, I was thinking of his channel, and then I was thinking, horror. And then Deadly is something that I wanted from the start. But I was thinking of Deadly Phantom. That didn't sound right. Then I had Deadly Horror. That sounded right. And then I needed to pick a last name. So I picked 101 because it's a throwback to my original channel.
How did your persona come to be?
Well, I started watching Mr. Nightmare's videos, and then I kind of heard, I kept on hearing the same narrations over and over again. So I decided to create my own channel, and that's it.
Do you have any future plans for your channel?
Tons. I actually have an upcoming series that is written by three writers. By the one of the writers go by different names, so I'm gonna name him Short Story One here in this one. Then I have Dr. Sir Creepypasta. He changed his name again. Then we have Rainer Lewington working on one of the plot lines. We have three plot lines with three different writers writing the plot lines.
How has narrating changed you and your and sorry, how has narrating changed you and your life?
Well, not much really, but I'm getting socially active more. That's good.
Why did you start narrating?
Well, I wanted to impress my girlfriend at the time, and it turned out into something more once me and her broke up, and it was seemed like an escape from reality.
What creepypasta do you want to narrate, but are having trouble doing so?
Okay, it's actually Rainer Lewington's story. It's called Cairo, and it's a long story, and I just haven't got down to it.
Which creepypasta has made an impact on your life?
Well, Candle Cove, actually, because that was the first story I read right through without stopping and like going paragraph by paragraph, because that would have took a long time to do, and I decided I wasn't going to do that in this one because it was my favorite creepypasta, and I wanted to do it right. I did it perfect without any editing the first time. Well, not the first time. It was about the fifth time I tried doing it. I narrated the full thing in full, and yeah.
Which creepypasta will you not narrate?
Any that has to do with either rape or anything like that, because I had a trouble doing one subscriber special a few months ago. I actually cried during the video because of what happened to the person, and I don't encourage people to watch. That's the only video I don't want people watching.
And we are on the last question for you. What is a fun fact about yourself?
Let me think on this one. God bless. Fuck. I can't think of one.
Okay. No hobbies or collections or any special talents you have?
Video games. Usually, yeah, I play a lot of video games. Special talents would be probably narrating. What was the other one?
Anything that you collect or any cool items that you loan or something?
Anything that I collect. I do not collect anything at the moment.
Okay. Well, that is it for the questions. Is there anything you'd like to say before we wrap this up?
Not really.
Okay. To anyone who hasn't already, check the description down below for a link to his channel. Go subscribe, comment, like, show lots of love and support. Thank you very much for joining me today. And that's it for now. So, bye everyone.
Bye.